Hi. Buenos dias. Welcome to Sesame Street.
Hold it right there, would you?
Oh, hi, forgetful.
How you doing,
Luis.
Yeah. Hey, could I ask you a question?
Sure, go ahead.
What was it that you just said a minute ago?
Oh, well, I was welcoming everybody back to Sesame Street.
No. I mean before that. You said something I didn't understand.
Oh, I said buenos dias.
Oh, yep, that's it.
Buenos dias.
Yep, that's it. You suppose you could tell me what that means?
What it means?
Mm-hmm.
I'll do something better than that.
Better?
I'll sing you a song about it.
You'll sing me a song?
Wait, what's that?
Woo-wee! Boy!
Buenos dias means good morning.
Oh!
Buenos dias every day.
I see.
Buenos dias when you meet someone as you go on your way. Buenos dias, say it proudly, whenever you would say, have a pleasant, happy, perfectly wonderful day.
Huh? Yeah, sounds fine to me.
Buenos dias, that's what it means.
Oh, gee whiz.
Buenos dias, David.
Oh, buenos dias.
How are you?
Real good.
Good.
Hey, buenos dias.
Yeah, same to you.
Have a perfectly wonderful day, David.
Hey.
Oh,
David.
Works with everybody, huh? Sure, yeah.
Hi,
oh. Luis. Ah, buenos dias, Olivia.
What did you say?
Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, oh. Have a good day.
Buenos dias, forgetting
thank
both.
Thank you.
Buenos dias.
Yeah, oh, I wonder if you can say it to just about anybody.
Buenos dias. Oh, buenos dias. Super. Buenos dias.
You can't say. Oh, thanks. Gee whiz, you're right, it works.
Buenos dias means good morning.
Good morning.
Buenos dias. Every day.
Every day.
Buenos dias when you meet someone as you go on your way.
Buenos dias.
Say it proudly. Yeah. Whenever you would say, have a pleasant, happy, perfectly wonderful day. Huh?
Wow.
Buenos dias, say it.
Buenos dias.
You got it, that's it.
I thought so. Tell me, can you say them words to just about anybody?
Oh, sure, anybody.
Well, thanks a lot.
Why are these party hats always so neat?
Hey, furry fella. Buenos dias.
What did you say to me?
I said, buenos dias.
Buenos dias?
Mm-hmm.
That means good morning.
Mm-hmm.
How dare you say that to me? Why, I'm a grouch. I hate good mornings. Why would you say a thing like that to me?
Well, what's his name over there said I could say it to anybody. Yeah, well, gee, maybe I better go home and write a song, Never Say Buenos Dias to a Grouch. Ah!
Well, that's a good idea.
What's a good idea?
Write a song.
What song? Buenos dias.
Oh, my goodness. What is all this noise? Telly, what's the matter, honey?
Well, Oscar's having a party and he didn't invite me.
Oh, well, did you tell him you wanted to come?
Yes, I did. But he said I was too nice. And I'd embarrass him in front of his grouch friend.
Oh, he did he?
Yeah.
Well, trust me, I'm going to get you into Oscar's party.
You are?
Yeah.
Well, how?
Well, I'm going to turn you into a grouch.
Me?
Yeah. First, you got to have something grouchy to wear. Let's see.
Something grouchy to wear?
Yeah, let's see what we can make out of this brown paper bag. That ought to be pretty grouchy.
That's grouchy?
Sure. Wait, when I get done with it, it will be.
Okay. Gosh. Oh, I see. It's a grouch hat.
Yeah. Can you see?
Yeah, sort of.
Yeah,
I can see, kind of.
Now,
right.
See, make that up. Now, doesn't that make you feel grouchier?
Yeah. you mean I pass for a grouch now?
No.
Right?
Now
right?
You gotta act like a grouch. You gotta act grouchy too. See?
I'll never be able to do that.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. Cause I'm gonna teach you how.
You are?
Yeah. Okay. Now I'm gonna get Oscar to come out here, and when I do, you gotta say real grouchily to him. You gotta say this, Oscar, I don't want to come to your party, cause you're not grouchy enough for me.
But I do want to go to the party. They've started in the pool already.
Terry, wait a minute. I know you want to go to the party, but you see, a grouch wouldn't say that. So come on. Now put your body in. Let me hear you.
Okay. Oscar, I don't think I want to go to your party.
No, Telly, grouchier. Like this. Oscar.
Yeah.
I wouldn't set foot in your party if it was the last party on this earth.
Okay, I got it. Hey, Oscar, I wouldn't set foot in that party of yours if it was the last party on earth unless you asked me.
No, Telly, he's not going to ask you to the party unless you get meaner and grouchier. You gotta raise your voice a little bit and say, Oscar, I've had it with you. I'm telling you, I wouldn't come to your party if you got down on your knees and begged me.
All right, Susan. You can come to the party.
Oh, hi. Hey, you're just in time to hear a story. It's called The Mermaid Queen, and I hope you like it because I made it up myself. They're going to help me out. See, they're all dressed like mermaids. You know what a mermaid is? It's a person who's half fish and half person. Okay, now listen carefully to my story. Once upon a time, there was a very old mermaid queen who decided it was time for someone else to wear her crown.
I will give my crown, she told the other mermaids, to whoever can repeat the magic words which I keep locked away in my treasure chest.
A little mermaid, would you open up this treasure chest here? And when the treasure chest was opened, bubbles came out, and they sounded like words, and the words sounded like bubble glub, bubble glub, 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 bubbly glub.
Bubble.
Now, those were the magic words. Bubble glub, bubble glub, glubble glub, glub, glub. And then the mermaid queen asked each mermaid if they could repeat them. Dana Mermaid, can you say those words? Try it. Anna, can you say them?
Bubble, 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 bubble.
Pretty good, but not quite right. How about you, Keisha?
Bubble, 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 bubble.
Pretty good, but not right on. How about you?
Bubble, glub, bubble, bubble. That's what she's trying to say.
Yeah, well, pretty
bubble,
close.
Bubble.
Oh, dear, said the mermaid queen.
Bubble, not one bubble, of the mermaids bubble. Could repeat my words exactly right.
She couldn't find anyone to give the crown to. Until one day, when there was a knock at the door. And in came a mercow.
Hello, I am a mercow. A cow that swims underwater. Yes, bubble glub, bubble glub, bubbly glub, glub, glub.
Why, the mermaid queen couldn't believe her ears. Could you say that again? She asked.
Well, I can try. Bubble glub, bubble glub, bubbly glub, glub, glub.
Close enough, she said. That was it. The mercow had said the magic words.
I did.
Oh. So the mermaid queen took her crown and she put it on the mercow's head.
Oh, how divine.
And so the mercow became queen of the mermaids and everybody lived happily ever after.
By the way, what does bubble glub, bubble glub, bubbly glub, glub, glub mean?
Oh, it means that that's the end of my story. Did you like it?
Yeah!
Oh, good.
So tell me seriously, do I look beautiful?
Yeah!
Oh, ha, 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 ha. Glubbity glub?
Glubbity glub, glubbity glub.
Oh, it's so much fun being a mercow.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters A and H and by the number 3. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.